me, the act of painting is just reaching to that other side of the unknown. And so I'm always looking for this connection to something that is just like an ancient tidbit of knowledge that is probably worthless, but on the other hand, it could be that secret clue that you need to the treasure. The treasure is knowledge. You know, the treasure is discovering something that brings meaning and purpose, you know, and so for art, you know, it's always about finding relevance and purpose and the idea that it's not just putting paint on canvas, it's experiencing something that's bigger than the act of painting itself. Curiosity, this how I can connect the dots to information and knowledge that is just buried between the cracks, ancient mysticism to contemporary science.
My work has been about defining synecdoches. It's defined by William J.J. Gordon as a system of beyond brainstorming, where a person is generally unaware of what they're actually doing. It's kind of like the, I think what Daniel Pink calls the third drive. You know, it's something that it's kind of bigger than you are. It's about relationships, you know, and I mean a lot of it. And I'd say that, you know, synecdoches is kind of like this brainstorming where a person is generally unaware of where they're going with it. For me, the work has evolved where now there's just more reference to what it is I was trying to do. It's like shattering a big piece of glass, and you see it on the floor, and it's a big giant pile of shards. But the fact is that every single one connects to another one, and with seemingly like chaos. I mean, artists should be incredibly self-reliant. Art, to me, is about freedom.